I'm in the city streets of Nairobi. Nimekutana na dance crew inaitwa Art in Motion. Now ndio na interview leo. So acha tusikie kile wako nayo kusema. Sasa niaje. Mko poa?
Kabisa.
Art in Motion. Art in Motion, right?
Yeah. Yep.
Why Art in Motion? Niambieni kwa nini mlidecide kujita hako kajina?
Art in Motion is because we decided to solidify things, because you know, this is the truth, is because people, like at the time we were choreographing in separately, and so people will try to steal my stuff, sometimes try to steal his stuff, so we decided to bring it together and call it Art in Motion.
My name is Kevin Givendu. I'm a graduate from KCA with an IT. We tulimaliza kusoma, alafu we decided to do this full time. We've quit jobs before just to do this, and yeah, it's coming out great.
Nice. Bobo, I'm not gonna share my other name. I studied economics, and this is what I decided to do.
Who is this one artist when you feel? Hey, mazijo to perform na umse na kuto hip yani.
For me, I'd say June Kashui. She's legit. She's a legit artist. In terms of dancing, singing, production, when it comes to like doing her shows and everything, we are so honored to be like part of her and being her choreographers and stage directors.
Nezabanda kuwa kuna nani Africa and internationally?
Wizkid, a lot of Niger, SA. I think I'm open. Like even like Diamond, I'm cool. I'd just love to work with someone outside our borders just to feel how their culture is.
I would honestly like to work with somebody like Fino, you know. Wizkid and Davido is of course, because there's big fish. My Sakodi, Drake.
Which style of dance do you guys do?
We do African, that is Afro, hip hop and urban contemporary.
Where do you see Kenyan dance in the next 5 years?
I hope that it will have grown. That probably, maybe we're going to be having like legit classes where people can come in and actually learn this craft, other than just following what international people do, who actually have classes. You know, they're actually based. So, coping, I feel like people need to learn.
We hope in 5 years, dance itacha kuonekana like an orb, you know, like a university wamta, you know, like. We don't like it at all.
What would be your advice to someone who's upcoming in the industry?
Learn your craft. Don't just ape and copy things. Actually take the time to study. Because even though there's no school, I think the YouTube tutorials, you know, and also have a spirit of wanting to know.
Also about that, like about learning, we love to help. We teach schools, we teach kids, we teach, you know, like, old people, all that. We do private lessons and everything. So I just want to let people know that there's this classes, we hold classes every Saturday at Salonika Villas Valley Arcade.
Well, thank you very much for creating time just to be here and inspiring the rest. That's it from Art in Motion. Hey, bust the move.
But Brian, you have too much fun on the streets of Nairobi. Why?
I love my job.
All right. Okay, fantastic. Speaking of loving our jobs, I just want to thank Mumo Liko. Thank you for coming. I'm director of Duo Tricks Media. And Angie Jagi, who would have made a video, a digital CV that went viral. And of course, Luo Dola. All right, well, I sent it to everyone for coming and being part of this panel. Let us read some of the feedback that we've been getting. There's one here by Moses that says, kudos to Luo Dola. Youth should stop being fed and find their own space by making use of what they have. All right, that is some of the feedback that we've been getting on today's show, unemployment amongst the youth. Of course, my name is Nzinzi Kibiko, and Brian, why are you looking so amazing today?
I look like this. I look like a bag of money because I have been dressed by City Walk. They've helped me walk with style. You can actually get some BEA beautiful colored clothes.
All right. Now, if you're a fan of weddings or plan to get married, this is why you should be watching Friday Briefing, the show that comes immediately after this right here on KTN News. But for now, we'll leave you with Technoid. My name is Nzinzi Kibiko.
And the hottest man in Eastern Central Africa, Brian Aseli.
All right. Bye-bye.
Good night.
Today on Tech Corner, we're in Westlands. We're visiting a firm known as Craft Silicon Campus. Now, they are responsible of building one of the local apps right here that we're using in Kenya and taking the taxi service by storm. And that app is known as Little Cabs. Of course, they've come in joint conjunction with Safaricom. And get this, the people behind it, the developers rather, are between the ages of 20 to 26. Incredible, right? So we'll get to talk to some of them, ask them the tough questions, such as the opportunities within the tech industry, some of the challenges that they faced when they were developing this app. So come in with me.
We felt that there was a demand for a local partner, somebody who really understands this industry, somebody who can really come up with something that drives. Uber is, yes, it's a good product. But again, you know, Google was not the first search engine. Yeah? So we thought there is an opportunity for us to come up with something that can help us to leap forward.
We needed to create a product, okay, analyze, then develop, then maintain and do some testing, all in about 2 months. The Kenyan market can be really unforgiving, especially since this product is actually out in the market, so they'll use this product compared to other products already existing.
I have a friend of mine who was working with Uber, then she had of this little cup. And I thought I should try it, by the way, and I tried it. Reason why, you know, she had told me first to engage Uber, but I didn't get interested.
Little Cabs came, they had an idea. We felt it was a good idea. It was a Kenyan idea. One of the things about Safaricom is that we're very proud of Kenya and our Kenyan roots, and we're very proud of localizing global things to make them truly Kenyan, giving them a Kenyan flavor.